Now, in this video, we will discuss three topics. Necessary evil. Friction is necessary evil. ये बुराई है, बुरा है, not good. And method of reducing the friction. And third is motion of a body on inclined plane. So, why it is necessary evil? Without friction, motion is not possible. We can't not form any building. Bricks will fall down. So, it is necessary. On the other hand, cloth, our shoe, different part of machine will get wear and tear. Toot foot jate hain due to friction. Heat develop hoti hai. So more fuel is required. When there is friction, more fuel is required to rotate the wheel or the machine. Lubricants are necessary at that time. So it is an evil. Ye bura hai. So it must be reduced. Isko kaise kam kare? By polishing the surfaces, those who are in contact. By using lubricant, just like mobile oil, etc. grease. By using ball bearing at the place of wheel and streamlining to make them boat shape, just like the bird beak shape. And by selecting of proper material, just like we make the tires of rubber and road of concrete, because between concrete and rubber friction is very small. So these are some methods. Sometimes it is necessary that friction must be more. In cold countries, when snow falls, then road gets slippery. So sand is sprinkled, ret chhidakte to increase the friction so that we can move. Motion on an inclined plane. Suppose this is an inclined plane. It is inclined at right angle from horizontal. It is horizontal plane, vertical plane. A block of mass m is placed here. So its weight will act vertically downward. Weight is a vector quantity, so there will be two components of it. One is mg cos theta and another mg sin theta. Mg cos theta is equal opposite to the r, so we will cancel to each other. If suppose block is at rest, then at contact surface the friction will be upward while mg sin theta will be downward. So both will be equal and opposite because block is at rest, so net force is zero. Rest mein to net force zero means Fs equal mg sin theta and R equal mg cos theta, so all will cancel each other, it will be at rest. If we divide equation 2 by 1, so sin theta upon cos theta, tan theta is equal to Fs upon R. And you can say tan theta equal Fs equal mu s R upon R by third law of limiting friction, so it is mu s. This is the relation between angle of friction and coefficient of static friction. As well as the theta increases, the mg sin theta also increases, its value increase and it will become to Fs. After that, just if we increase the, this angle, then it just start to slide. That angle is called angle of repose. Wo angle jis par ye block slip hona, slide karna start kar de, angle of repose. Value of theta at which the body just start to slide down is called angle of repose. So at that time, here, because body is sliding down, moving down, so it has an acceleration. Suppose acceleration is A, then mg sin theta minus Fs. Suppose it is 10, it is 7. So it is 10, it is 7. So 3 Newton is bringing the body downward, and that is the dynamic force, F is equal to ma. So dynamic force F is equal to ma will be equal to the mg sin theta minus F. And both are in motion, so we will put here K, not S. And M is equal to mg sin theta K. And FK is equal to mu K R, but R is equal to mg cos theta. So FK is equal to mu K R and R is equal to mg cos theta. By this equation, M will be cancelled. We can calculate the acceleration of the body by which the body is coming slide down.